Gone to Heaven. I have two of my favorites. Well, three of my favorites. Toby from Le Coq Culinaire is here. But also, we have pumpkin ale and chili. Look at that. It's baked in a pumpkin, and Le Coq Culinaire, of course, off of Ward Parkway. And our chef is here to tell us all about it. How do you make this?
Okay, well, I'm pretty sure most people have a couple pumpkins lying around.
Oh, yeah, after last night.
You know,
sure.
Something happened yesterday. So basically what we're going to do is we're just going to make kind of a basic chili, but pumpkin is going to add a little bit of sweetness and also a little bit of nuttiness to the chili. Pumpkin has a flavor very similar to, like, butternut squash, acorn squash, stuff like that.
Because we're so used to tasting in a pumpkin pie,
right,
where a lot of the flavor is actually masked with all the sugar
exactly.
and evaporated milk.
Well, we're bringing that sweetness out of the pumpkin out with spice.
I like
and things
it.
Like that. So we started with, we got a couple pounds of ground beef, some onion and some poblano pepper. If you want to make it spicier, you can use jalapeno. You can use whatever pepper you want, however much pepper, however much onion. You can also use turkey in this. If you want to make it vegetarian, you can, and just use beans. But now we're going to get into our spices. We're going to have our we got our regular chili spices. We've got chili powder and cumin. Now we're going to add the pumpkin spice. Pumpkin spice is cinnamon, nutmeg, clove, and ginger.
So like for a pumpkin pie mix,
right,
you put that in there?
Yeah. And what I do is whenever I make chili, I always add cinnamon to my chili, so this kind of works with me.
And that's a flavor that people go, huh, there's something different, but
right,
I don't know what that
exactly.
is.
Exactly. There's a famous Mexican sauce called a mole.
Yeah.
And it uses a lot of those savory spices that you would associate with baking.
Wish you could smell that.
And
that
so this kind of goes along with that. Then we're just going to add the rest of our ingredients. We're going to add our pumpkin. This is canned, but you can use fresh. You just want to roast it off
tomatoes
in the oven and scoop it out. So we got some diced tomatoes, our beans. This is just a little bit of beef base. You
What's
can leave that?
That
out if you want. It's just like bouillon, basically.
Okay.
Okay. It's just going to add a little more beefy flavor and add a little salt for us. Tomato paste, just to kind of give it a little roasted tomato
and
flavor.
What's this?
This is Mexican chocolate.
Look at that.
Okay. This is another kind of take off that mole, all right? Chocolate is unsweetened, okay? So you want to use either Mexican chocolate or you can use baker's chocolate that doesn't have any sugar in it. That's going to help with the...
Here we go. Now we're
it's
cooking.
It's going to mix really well with the spices. And then, of course, our liquid component. You can leave the beer out if you must. You can use water or stock or something.
But it's pumpkin ale.
Also has that pumpkin spice in it as well. So what we're going to do is we're just going to stir that up. We're going to let that sit for about an hour.
Then
let
get
all the flavors
your pumpkin
mold
that you've carved out. Make sure it's not one of the jack-o'-lanterns because it'll leak out of the
right
eye.
You just carve out the middle, rub it with a little oil, put it in the oven for 30 minutes. The longer you cook it, the softer it'll get.
Can I have a bite out of there?
You can have a bite out of there if you'd like. That's perfectly fine. And it makes a great serving vessel. And then, of course, now you don't have a pot to wash. You throw it over the fence and
gosh,
let the deer eat it.
I like that.
So, yeah, it's a nice, interesting presentation.
I'm making this today.
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Wow.
It's going to be a good, sounds like it's going to be a good weekend for it.
I need to come to your cooking school and learn how to be a chef.
Please do.
I need a third, fourth
anytime
job.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I'm sure you do.